Welcome to another episode of The Space, a mindfulness podcast that's not like the others. I'm your host, Casey Donovan. Alongside Amy Malloy, we use every Monday to explore ways to get clear for the week ahead and feel creative and confident. Are you the kind of parent who chooses to homeschool their children? It's happening more than it used to. The numbers of children taking lessons at home was already on the rise before COVID, according to experts. It's a lot to manage, especially if you're also working. If you're working and you school your kids in any capacity, it can be very stressful. This is according to Leah Larwood, a clinical hypnotherapist who specializes in mindfulness techniques. Mindfulness can help you to manage the juggling act, she says. These tips can be useful whether you're homeschooling full-time or ending your workday with homework. Tip 1. Have a mindful morning check-in. Each day can present a new challenge, says Leah. Check in with yourself each morning to see how you're feeling. Are you in a place where you can genuinely handle both your own work and your child's schooling? Listen to your body and give yourself some leeway. What's really urgent and can be left out? Make a promise to drop perfectionism. If not for yourself, then for your children. Tip 2. Aim for mindful interactions. It's frustrating trying to finish an email when a kid is pulling on your sleeve. That much is true. It's tempting to say, just hang on a minute. But it's better to put your work on hold for a minute, says Leah. The fact is, you're not going to write that one email well or feel good as you do it. Instead, take a few minutes to have a meaningful interaction with your little one. That time with your child will top you both up. Hopefully, you'll have a hall pass to work for a while afterwards. Tip 3. Change your perspective. Remember when you were a kid and rearranging your room was a thrill? Research shows switching up your location can make you more creative and productive. Try swapping workstations, advises Leah. Set their schoolwork up in a different room. Sit yourself on the other side of the table. Changing up your immediate environment can allow you to look at things with a new perspective. And if it all feels too much, take a doona day together. Switch off your devices, bundle up in bed, take a mental health day. In addition to rest, you might notice a renewed sense of confidence, says Leah. It's a way to regain autonomy in the upside-downness of life. I'm Casey Donovan, and you've been listening to The Space. We're back tonight with another mood-soothing episode. How the butterfly technique can give your fears the flick. Space out.